All right, Frank's on. Woo! Let me just crank it. Woo! What is it? All right, so I'm bottom fishing. I'm actually gonna clear my line right now so it's out of the way. But just dealing with tough conditions. You know, the weatherman called for something different. Flat, calm, beautiful seas, and we just got a little bit of sporty seas and wind, which makes it difficult to bottom fish when it's windy and there's a current moving, so your boat is just moving so fast across the surface, you can't really present a bait correctly down on the bottom. So we have baits out on top, which are getting crushed, and that's awesome. We were just hoping for some more of like dinner fish, but this might be a dinner fish too. We don't know what it is yet, it hasn't jumped. Catch him, Frank. All right. Oh gosh, I'm connected, aren't I? Okay. I'm just trying to get this up, guys. I'm sorry I'm not talking to you. I feel like it might be sharked. Yeah. We're gonna see. But we're just struggling today, really trying to get fish to the boat. And we're losing a lot of bait to fish. Had those couple sailfish this morning, that was awesome. But as far as the bottom bite and everything else goes, it's just been a struggle. Looks like I got something on top. And it looks like it's a bonita on my bottom rod. Ugh, monster bonita. Oh, just got smashed by a sailfish. Sailfish right there. Oh my gosh. Sailfish on, 100%. Doubled up, guys, doubled up. Just struggling here because they've got like a 20-foot leader attached to my weight. I honestly don't know how I'm gonna land a bonita like this. There he goes. Sailfish. Sick.
We got a huge mess around here. Frank's line is almost full. Darcy's got to pick this up. We got tangles and a mess. Stupid bonita. Frank's about to get spooled on Darcy's snook rod. Let's go, Frank. All right, Frank's got him boat side. Darcy's put on her gloves.
Try like short cranks. There you go. There you go. He's turning. Perfect. Perfect. Watch out, watch out. Doing a circle. He might not be done. Oh, awesome. Oh, dude, he broke off. He's gone.
Oops.
That was no one's fault. Line was pretty tight there, and when they do those jumps last minute at the boat, you know, he ended up pulling the circle hook on himself. I mean, that wasn't Frank's fault, but that's like the third sailfish of the day. It's just a sailfish day out here, guys. He totally frayed that leader. Would have probably broke eventually here. So, you know, just dealing with tough conditions, but it's so cool to see him jump like that so close to the boat. Nice job, Frank, catching that fish.
Way to go, Frank. Darcy finally let you catch a fish.
Yeah, you're next
one. No, I caught a sailfish before. So we actually hooked three sailfish today, and that sailfish is actually a legal catch in a tournament because we got the leader. It was so close.
Yeah.
You're allowed a 12-foot leader in most tournaments, so that's no problem.
Yeah.
So that's two sailfish today. Got a bonita. We had some, I had some major audio problems in the beginning. I don't know if you saw the sailfish, but I had the first thing in a day, I threw a bait out. I think it hit a sailfish in the head because it jumped right out of the water. And then I got a sailfish hooked up. And then you can see here in this footage, the sailfish like came right into the boat and like slammed it in the side and made a noise. So we had some pretty crazy jumps. The wind brings the sailfish out, so we're having a great day so far. What do you think, Frank?
Great day, thank you very much.
You guys hear that? I didn't even hear it.
Say something, something.
Quiet, Frank. Let's go, Sizzle. Catch me something I can eat, Daddy's hungry.
All right, guys, hooked up again. We're just kind of traveling around, trying to find different ledges, explore the area, because we honestly don't fish Stuart quite enough. And this is only the second time we've actually taken our center console up here to Stuart. So we're just learning the area, and we just came across a really nice ledge, dropped down my live pilcher that we caught this morning, and I'm using like a pound of weight because of all of this heavy current that we have. So I'm trying to bring up this fish as fast as I possibly can with the sharks this time of the year. They love to eat your catch. Okay, color. Here comes the weight. Leader.
Frank, you can't see the fish from there, you goofball.
Get his lip. That'll work. Hey! We got a fish! Ah! All right, y'all, little nice size amberjack here we've got. This area in particular seems to hold a lot of amberjacks, but you just saw circle hook perfectly in the corner of the mouth, exactly what the circle hook should do. And today I am using a number 6-aught mustad inline circle hook. And that just hooked that fish perfectly. Woo. We are not gonna eat these bad boys. If I can control them. Oh my gosh. But we're gonna get them released here. A beautiful amberjack, check them out. Full of worms, but for us, we don't like to eat them, we like to release them.
I just wanna follow up what Darcy said about being in this new area. You know, we're just kind of looking at stuff and checking our low ranch depth finder. And I saw fish on there, so we stopped and we caught a fish. You know, so it's not magic. You know, you guys can do it too. It's super easy, really. It's common sense. What do you got, Frank? It's going too slow. It's going to be a sailfish. Don't crank it up yet.
Well, as long as it's not like really light. Yeah, you don't want it too loose.
We don't reel until sailfish start jumping. That's the rule.
Yeah, they took my bait right off the bat, as soon as I went down.
All right, Sizzle just got hooked up and lost the bait, and Frank's hooked up to something, I don't even know.
Oh, what is it, what is it?
I think it's gonna be a sailfish, but it could be a bonita. Welcome back, everybody. It's 2 hours later. Frank is still fighting a bonita.
Amberjack.
Amberjack.
Hooked up.
Sizzle's hooked up. Nice. Don't splash my camera with that fish, Frank. There you go. Nice job, Frank. You're in charge. Get him off the hook. Watch this thing for Sizzle. Don't let my beautiful girlfriend step on any of that. Frank, get those pliers. You owe me $1.
Snapper.
Frank, grab the rod. I got the rod.
Short. Right species, though. Right species, guys. That makes me excited. I might just catch a keeper. Look how beautiful they are though when they're young, juveniles. When there's baby fish like that, like usually in general, they're just so much prettier than the adults. That's the cool thing about catching them as well. You can see that he's blown up here as well, and circle hooks right in the corner of the mouth, always doing its job. That way these fish get hooked correctly. Whoa, he's mad. Whoa, he's mad.
From over.
Here he goes. And he's gone. Duck down to
Frank,
the deep.
Pick him up and throw him over. You just putting more holes?
He's fine.
You be the judge. Hey, was that nay?
All right, guys, we have switched it up. We're getting chased home a little. Ooh, my bait's going crazy. We're getting chased in from storms. So a lot of storms are offshore already. We made it in safely. So we're inside the inlet and now we are snook fishing at this prime snook spot. And we're trying to get Frank on a Mogan monster 40-inch snook. We got live baits out, basically freelining them, two lines. Frank's running one, I'm running one. We're gonna see what happens, but I'm just casting him out, letting him go with the current, leaving it freelined out. And then as soon as the line starts going crazy, I just lock it up and reel, because we're using circle hooks. Crossing my fingers, we can get one. Just let him eat it. Oh, that's your bait, don't pull him away. That was your bait, trying to eat it. Just freeline it. I just had a couple big explosions on Frank's bait. I don't know what happened, but the fish totally missed it. So that's a good sign, but we kind of have no current here. So it's all about current when it comes to saltwater fishing, guys. That's key to success in catching fish. So with the no current situation, we might get lucky, but it's more guaranteed when you have a lot of moving water, and currently we don't. So we'll give it another shot here. Ugh, get him out. All right, guys, hooked up. I hope we can land this fish. We've had like 3 or 4 snook bites already and just have not had luck to make them connect, keep them connected. So what Brian has been doing while Frank and I have been casting out live baits. Ooh, I don't think this is a snook now. I think it's a jack. Brian has been live baiting with all the live bait we have to get the fish fired up with, ooh, beauty. It's a snook, I was wrong. It's not a Mogan. Well, a snook is a snook, but it's not a huge, huge one, but it's still a beauty. Check her out. Oh, and Frank is over there. You're supposed to catch a fish. Now I feel bad because I caught the snook. I got him. Come here, come here. We got her. Let's get the hook. Can you pull the hook out real quick so I don't get hooked? Thank you. Our landing net broke yesterday, guys. There you go. Throw it back. Our landing net broke yesterday, guys. So today we forgot our other net, of course. But check out this beaut. Gorgeous fish. Didn't fight her very long at all, but that's a big breeder female snook. Let's get a quick measure and send her home. Always fun to catch and release these guys. That would be a slot fish. You know what? I've been trying to catch a slot fish through the end of 2018, the beginning of 2019, and never caught one. But of course I catch it when slot season's over. But now I feel really bad. I want to get Frank on his first snook here in the Stuart. Whoa, she's pretty mad. Check that out, still hanging out. You ready? Are you ready? Just hang on to her for a second, make sure she swims away. They head shake like that, that you know, they're ready, they're very active and ready to go. I did not fight this fish a very long time, but it takes her a second just to recoup. Usually happens with all fish. She'll be fine. Come on. You ready to go? Which way is the current going again?
She's very stiff, very slack.
There she goes. There she goes. I love when they swim away so slow like that. So cool. It's like they're saying goodbye. But pretty sweet. We got a snook in the boat. Just feel bad because the goal was to catch Frank one, not me. I catch snook all the time.
What did Frank just say, Sizzle?
He said, I've caught snook before, but not here in the Stuart Inlet, but it's okay, he appreciates the effort. I would more than willing try it again, give it another shot, but it's probably time to go. I'm not sure, it's Brian's call. Fish on? He's got one. He's got one. Don't tighten it too much. Line tight, rod tip up.
It's his first time, I
know. No, I know, it's okay. I wanna make sure he lands it.
Yes, I'm a little busy over here.
Nice! I see him, I see him. All right, all right, all right. We got him! Let me get this hook out. Barely hooked, Frank. All right, circle hook did its job perfectly in the top upper lip of the mouth. It should have been in the corner, but at least it's in the anywhere of the lip. That's perfect. I'm holding fish's Frank's fish. But this is a smaller snook in the part of the, that was really bad. But this is a smaller snook, guys, part of the inlet spawning. This is definitely a male. The male fish are a lot smaller than the females because the females are the breeders and the ones with the eggs. So we're gonna go ahead and release this bad boy, but Frank did a great job catching the snook. We did it. High five, air high five. Ooh, he's like trying to swim away, but he won't let go of my thumb. It's pretty funny. Come on. You're free. So cool. So cool to catch those awesome sport fish and pretty blessed and just, you know, blessed at the fact that we can catch amazing fish offshore and then also come inshore and catch snook. And it's all thanks to you guys watching. So I'm just really humble and blessed that you guys follow us on this journey. It's so cool to experience it with you guys and share it. And we're really blessed. And sometimes I get upset and stuff, but any day on the water is a good day, guys. Fish on. Circle hook. When you have the circle hook and the fish starts running, you don't really want to set the hook like you would on a bass. You just kind of close your bail and raise your rod tip up and let the fish run and set the hook. So that's why it looked like I was doing nothing there, but that's how circle hooks work, guys. And I highly recommend if you don't use circle hooks to use them for fresh water and salt water. It's just a great way to to make sure the fish don't get gut hooked and to make sure that, you know, you can release them properly if they need to be released. And I use mustad hooks only, so check those out. And also want to mention the fact that all the muskrat hooks, all the jigs, all the gear, all the lures, everything we love to use while we're fishing is located in my Amazon store. And I am an Amazon associate, so I do get paid on certain purchases. So if you want to support the channel, please check that out, guys. Lively, Snooky. Yeah! Open the bail! Check it out, guys. Beautiful snook. Circle hook right in the corner of the mouth, baby. Killing it. This fish is ready to go. She's gone. Beautiful, that's exactly what you want to see. We killed it today, heck yeah. So I think everything that brought me the good luck today was definitely my lucky fishing hook bracelets. Check them out on the website if you're interested, and you can support me, and I make hand tie them myself. But I also wanted to let you know I was filming the last one for my Instagram story, so please follow me there if you don't. I have a lot of stories and good posts and stuff you guys are missing out on. An epic day on the water. Like I said, so humbled and blessed today, and really just want to say thank you to each and every one of you. You guys just made this day for us. So until my next adventure, follow your dream and keep on catching.
Thanks, guys.